I would say that in the context of the character that I play, Hedda Hopper, like you guys, a journalist, and especially in the light of what's happened within the press and journalism here in this country in the last 3 or 4 years, it is also a story about the fearful power of the press and the way it can be, in a sense, misused, or at least when the press engages so immediately, if that's the right way of putting it, with the zeitgeist, is that the right word? Of the time, instead of challenging the zeitgeist. You know, my character just plays with the power of her journalism, plays to the fears and the paranoia of her public, and it is I think it shows us how very dangerous that power can be. We, in a sense, in Britain, benefited because some of the directors, in particular, I'm thinking of Joseph Losey, who, as I understand, was one of the people who had to leave America. And of course, we benefited in Europe from the brilliance of those directors. You know, Joe Losey, when I was first an actor, I would die to work with Joe Losey. He was the sort of preeminent art film director in working in Britain. So, that was an immediate sort of outfall of that time. I would play a character, as I do in this movie, perpetuating different ideas within the context of this sort of film. But no, I wouldn't commit to a film. I have quite a broad, understanding of life in general. But no, if a film was politically pushing an agenda that I very strongly disagreed with, I could not partake in that at all, no. Playing the character, which is one thing, and being in a film that is perpetuating a concept or an idea that you have absolute that you absolutely don't agree with. Do you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
I think there are two different things there. Yeah, I mean, absolutely, you can play characters whose lifestyle or whose attitude or whose actions you can profoundly disagree with. The difficulty is always to find your personal sympathy with that character, which is what we kind of have to do, isn't it, to make them real and human. That's one thing. But to be in a movie that is perpetuating politically, sending a message out to the audience that you profoundly disagree with, I think that would be not impossible for any of us, I think, as artists, yeah.
Do you have a personal favourite, or is there a...
Of all the hats
a number, yes.
Oh, I can't remember now. I loved all of them. I mean, I love hats, actually. It's my great sadness in my life that hats became something that people didn't wear anymore. I loved every single one. I mean, my costumes in general were just such a laugh, you know. They were so brilliant. Our costume design was amazing. A lot of them were original vintage pieces, and then he had extra pieces made. What fun to be able to wear hats for once in a movie. That was really great.
Did you have fun?
Daily, dear. Yes.
Helen, did you have fun going back and reading Hedda Hopper's columns and watching those?
I watched.
Reels?
I don't know about how much fun it was. I've never been a great fan of celebrity journalism. even when I wanted
present
to
know, company
the present company excepted. Even when I sort of wanted to be an actress and I was sort of dreaming about it, I didn't dream about it through reading, fanny sort of those sorts of things. I find it kind of boring, actually, I'm afraid to say. Her. I was more interested in reading about her. I did read a very interesting book, which was all about the letters that were sent to her, which really gave you a view into the mindset of very ordinary people in America at that time. So that was very interesting.
What you would have thought of Hedda if you'd actually met her? And on a sort
She would have scared the shit out of me, absolutely. Both of those, you know, and the Walter Winchells of the world. And there are a lot of journalists who scare the shit out of me, quite honestly, you know, nowadays. You know, in our business, we have to be open to the press, and I think we all feel it's part of our job, you know, it's very much part of our job. But at the same time, you're always on a, you know, you're always about to fall off the wire, you know, into the pit below of snarling snakes and serpents.
Present company.
No, I'm really talking about the comments, you know, the comment part of the internet, that sort of world. You might tumble in. We all tumble into it regularly, I guess. So it's all a bit nerve-wracking. It's part of our job, absolutely, an essential part of our job, and you know, we're very grateful to you guys for being in this room today when you could be somewhere else. You know, we're very grateful to you for turning up and doing what you're doing.